America West Arena here in Phoenix, Arizona. That's the site of tonight's hockey game between the Detroit Red Wings and the Phoenix Coyotes. Yeah, for the Red Wings on the East Coast last weekend, as far as Saturday on Long Island, and now a five-game road trip that takes them not only to the Southwest, but the West Coast as well. For the Red Wings, that means they've had a week of rest. They should be a well-rested team, and the bruises and cuts should be pretty much healed before they take on the Phoenix tonight. Talking about Phoenix, we go the other way because they just completed a seven-game road trip where they won only one game and dropped six. Igor Larionov, quite a player. He's been doing a great job for the Red Wings. In fact, he has been one of their most consistent players of the year. And Kenny Holland, the general manager, says a pleasant surprise. Of course, it'll be Sergei Fedorov sitting out the first game of his five-game suspension. And this will be the third meeting between these two teams, both games in the previous times belonging to the Phoenix Coyotes, 3-1 and 6-2. We're going to join Ken Daniels and Mickey Redmond right after we take our first timeout.
Phoenix, where the Red Wings kick off their five-game, 12-day road trip after having five full days off. Hello again, everyone. Ken Daniels alongside Mickey Redmond. And speaking of 5 days off, five games off for Sergei Fedorov, as Ray Lane talked about, it means Kirk Maltby gets the big promotion.
Well, other people get a chance to play. I don't think it's any surprise to people in the organization that Sergei got 3 to 5 games and an awful lot of money, almost $400,000. But it does give a chance for other guys to get into the play. Maltby, whereby the warm-up, is going to play with Steve Yzerman. That's a good break for him. And, of course, there'll be some other shuffles as well. But you know what? I guess we get past the money and the fine. The time off not going to do them all that bad either coming down the stretch here.
And hopefully the time off will do the Red Wings some good. You remember the great start the Phoenix Coyotes got off to? 17 consecutive games allowing 2 goals or fewer. But ever since then, they began the season 17-3-3. And then the first 30 games overall, in the last 9, they've won but one.
Yeah, they just have not been able to put it together. And like the Red Wings in December, where everybody went south at the same time, no pun intended, of course, we're here in the desert, but the Phoenix Coyotes have really gone dry. And especially their two big guys, Roenick and Tkachuk, have really gone dry in the goal-scoring department. If they don't score, those guys, Phoenix has got a problem.
Roenick, Tkachuk, Tocchet accounting for 43% of the Phoenix Coyote goals. So for elsewhere, they look for a former Red Wing in Dallas Drake.
Well, I think Dallas Drake is a guy that gives you more than just goals. Now, Drake has missed 17 games with an assortment of injuries. But what Drake gives you, I think he's playing when he plays with Roenick and Tkachuk. He opens up the ice for those guys. He's a gritty player, loves to go in the corners, and it leaves those guys some more room to work their magic. So I think Drake being back, this is just his second game back, big plus for those guys.
Well, with all the snow in Detroit, we hope we can at least bring you some good news here from Phoenix tonight. The Red Wings can pull out a win. Always sunny, not at night, but a beautiful time in Phoenix. We got a great game next with a lot on the line on UPN 50. Welcome back to America West Arena. Our goaltenders tonight for the Red Wings, Chris Osgood, who hasn't played since the 5-5 tie with Florida a week ago tonight. Wings 13th in the league in team defense. Phoenix still fourth thanks to the early season heroics, but on the recent trip of 7 games allowed an average of nearly 4 per game. Jimmy Waite, just off a 2-week conditioning stint in Springfield, had struggled prior to that. Nikolai Habibulin out with a groin injury, and that is why he is not in the lineup tonight. Don Van Massenhoven is the referee, the former Ontario Provincial Police officer, and we're underway. We talked about Kirk Maltby getting that promotion to the top line. He starts up front with Yzerman and Shanahan, but good play by Maltby. Drake there to take, hit the goal post, another shot, and right off the bat, the man Mickey Redmond talked about in the opening, Dallas Drake, gets a great opportunity, and Osgood with some help from his best friend, the goalpost. Knocked down, Newman, and sends one through. And the Red Wings will get it to the line, but not out. Murphy can't clear. Deep for Roenick, knocked down. Lidstrom, Roenick to intercept again. Got help from Drake. Roenick up high, knocked down, bouncing puck taken by Yzerman. He's all alone as the Red Wings change it up. And they'll need that change if this opening minute is any indication. Sent down, pocket in a race with Dandino. Gets there with those big feet to stop that puck. Icing against Phoenix. Let's take a listen, though, in the opening 20 seconds, the goalpost. Oh, that clunk. And that puck stayed out.
Now Dallas Drake doesn't score a ton of goals, even in his best times. He will not do it. Let's look at the scratches for tonight's game. The big guy, Javi Bolin, out for Jim Schoenfeld. Defenseman Didik, big forward, Isbister. Adams and Jurke Lume, a big loss for them. And the Red Wing list continues to stay the same, except tonight you've got Anders Ericsson out and the veteran McCowan back in.
Off the draw, Kozlov feeds across, Cannon on the shot, and it missed the goal of Jimmy Waite. So Lapointe digging in there along with Bob Corkin, one of the better defensive players. Igor Larionov, one of the best at offense. Set it there.
Yes.
What a shot! Kozlov roped it from Larionov, and it's 1-0. Just a minute 10 into the hockey game.
They'll review this as Lapointe is right on the front dot, left corner of the crease. I think he's just outside, and he's the one really that started the whole play off by keeping two Phoenix players off the puck, and Larionov could take it in behind. Watch Lapointe on the right side. Yeah, he's off the right side. He gets there just as the puck is coming back out. It'll stand easily, and it's 1-0. Van Massenhoven standing right by the scorekeeper and got the okay. Said, okay, let her go, boys. Drop the puck, and Red Wings get one early, and that could hurt Phoenix because they have stumbled big time on the road trip. It's their first game back, and their confidence is very, very slight right now.
Well, that's Slava Kozlov's first in four games, the first since his hat trick in Buffalo, but hasn't even on a roll. 7 goals his previous 15 games. Coming into this one tonight, and he gets his 18th goal of the season, 1-0 for the Red Wings.
See where he put it too, boy, right up in the top corner as Waite was going down.
A huge one considering the 5 days off. To not want to fall into that lull. The team was energized the past few days through practice, seemed to have new life, and to get a big goal early is huge. Here's McCarty up there along with Holmstrom. McCarty turning, Draper goes to the slot, out of the corner to get it. Kozlov from Larionov and McCowan at 1:10, the time of that goal.
McCarty looking to get in trouble at center ice. That's not the last of that we've seen.
Here's Draper. Opposite corner.
McCarty got whacked. He got whacked.
Penalty coming up to Phoenix.
It was Sean Gagnon, number 48, that he was fencing with at center ice, and then McCarty came down looking for a pass from Draper, and Gagnon hit him on the foot or the ankle, and that's not what Phoenix needs either early in their hockey game. And down 1-0 is to put Detroit on the power play. Watch McCarty get chopped as he goes through the middle. Interesting. I'd like to see that in slow motion. He might have got speared up inside the right knee.
Gagnon had 330 penalty minutes last season in Springfield of the A, so he's used to stuff like this.
Well, he also knows McCarty's reputation too, and maybe he's trying to get something going early. But you don't want to put your team shorthanded, and McCarty's shaken up, being attended to by John Wharton. And 10%, and the Coyotes doing well. Second in the league in the penalty kill, and just under 90%.
Phoenix's penalty killing their past 5 games, 12 for 15, second best.
This is the Office of Disaster Preparedness. A snow condition code yellow is now in effect for the city of Ann Arbor and Washtenaw County. Hazardous driving conditions exist with heavy snow and or ice, drifting and limited visibility. Please drive with reduced speeds. Main highways are being maintained in fair condition, but local roads may be impassable. Motorists are urged that if they must drive, use extreme care and allow a significant drive time. WPCT 5.
Ice as Roenick and Tkachuk head off. Igor Larion off. Nice behind the back pass. Here comes Eisenman across center. He'll send a high one in opposite corner left wing side. And the Coyotes will slap it 200 feet. This is the third of four meetings between these two clubs. They'll meet again back in Detroit on St. Paddy's Day, March 17th. Peter Klima can't bust through. Stapleton sent it down the ice. Number 14, Mike Stapleton, son of Pat Stapleton. Doug Brown will start it. Brown a lead feed to Larry Murphy. Ahead for Peter Klima. Back after that rib injury, and they're offside at that Phoenix blue line.
Well, it's 1-0. Let's take a look at how this thing all happened. Larionov made the play to Kozlov. Boy, he wasted no time in going right up top over the left shoulder of Jimmy Wake. That's where to put it. Goaltender not going to stop that kind of a shot when it's coming at him as quickly as he turns his head to look forward. Doesn't hit him, it's in.
Kozlov with his 18th of the season at 25 last campaign. So on pace to equal that, certainly. And a personal best of 36 goals back in the 95-96 season. But ever since he's been united with Igor Larionov, he's been on a roll.
He's gambling more offensively, and Igor's picking up the defensive responsibility, and that's a big load off your mind when you only got to think about one thing, basically.
Peter Klima back there with Murphy. Brown takes it in the middle. To Holmstrom, he'll wheel around. Shanahan, first man in to get it, swept it back for Klima. Behind the goal, Keith Kearney. He got there first, ahead for Keith Tkachuk. And he'll send it back, and this should kill off the rest of the Red Wing power play. Gagnon with 5 seconds left in his penalty. Holmstrom to Shanahan. He knifed it back in and cleared out. Gagnon out of the box. Brought on by McCowan. Back for Holmstrom. Draper to the front of the goal. Bouncing puck still in the corner. Sent around by J.J. Daniel. Back in front, opposite side now. Getting over there, McCowan toward the goal. Deflected in front. Another shot in front. Oh, and Holmstrom just couldn't get his stick on it. McCowan, smart play to put it back in front. And the Red Wings nearly made it 2-0.
Interference penalty coming up to Dandenong. Now Detroit comes close again. They've got one by Kozlov, but the Phoenix Coyotes will go on the power play in a moment when we return.
Matthew Dandenong in the box for interference, so the Coyotes go to their first power play. We're on the Mishkon shorthanded challenge this time for Mike Gargano of Royal Oak. If the Wings score during this penalty kill, Mike will win $50 in Red Wing merchandise. The Red Wings have scored 8 shorthanded goals this season. Maltby getting one recently, and here they go. Eisenman up with Murphy, pass across, and the return feed was intercepted. All the Red Wings come close in the opening 10 seconds shorthand.
Murphy tried to pass it back to Eisenman, did not elect to take the shot.
Osgood had slowed it down, Tkachuk in the corner. Along with number 8, Briere, the rookie, Daniel Briere is on it. Here's Tkachuk, high slot, pass back, Darren Quint, the shot, stop, and cleared out the back door as Murphy saved one in his own end. Another shot, Osgood, big stop, another one out of the air, knock it down, they score.
They're calling it in. Osgood complaining to Van Massenhoven that there should have been a whistle.
Well, the light still hasn't gone on.
They're plowing the front of the net, and the linesman now is talking to the referee. And he's... What a strange play. Overhead, look at it. What do we got? Osgood got interfered with by Roenick. That's his complaint. Then Tkachuk pulls down Murphy. No penalty there. There's a guy in the crease. Guy in the crease. Tkachuk is in the crease.
Yes.
This
play
goal
is under
should
review.
Be called back. I got to look at that other angle one more time, guys, because see the puck. Well, I don't know.
Puck
see, the thing is, the
first.
Puck may have gone in there first, And if it didn't come back out, then this goal is going to stand.
I think the puck was there first, Mick, and in that case...
It was. The question is, did it go back out and then back in again?
I don't think it did.
Now let's take another look again. There it's in, but where is it now? They can't see where it is.
The goal is good.
And you only got a foot on the outside over here to the crease, and you couldn't see that area for Osgood's body, but they're going to let the goal stand. Wasn't any question about Tkachuk being in the crease, but you couldn't see whether the puck came back out after it entered the blue area.
So the Phoenix Coyotes get a power play goal, the second worst power play in the league. 26th gets a goal.
He's saying blow the friggin' whistle is what he said to Ben Bessonhoven.
How do you spell friggin'?
Any way you want. In many languages.
Osgood stopped that one. There's another shot that went wide.
No place for a nervous person, boy, in an NHL game. If you're a referee, you're in big time trouble.
Phoenix with lots of pressure now. Another penalty coming up.
Phoenix is throwing the body around, and they've been responsible for most of the hitting so far. And this place is absolutely rocking.
Coyotes will be shorthanded here. You mentioned hits. They lost to Boston on Tuesday by one, but they had 51 hits. And to a man, the Coyotes felt, okay, we lost that game. We lost 6 of 7 on the recent road trip. But Jim Schoenfeld's team finally was hitting. 51 hits they totaled that night. They finally came out with some spunk.
Bruins too.
Yes, and they're trying to continue that here tonight early on.
Well, that can be okay too, but also if the other team's power play is going to work, that's going to put your team in trouble. And Detroit will go back to the power play for the second time now. Now, the goaltender interference, Scotty Bowman's going to say to Van Matsenhoven, you should have called that the last time when Roenick buzzed through the crease on the power play and knocked Osgood down. And that led to the goal. I can't hear for the crowd here. Is it goaltender interference? Is that what they call?
Don't have it yet. Tkachuk from Roenick and Briere was the power play goal.
Shane Doan gets the penalty. We'll find out for what here in a second.
So our Bell Tire power play partner on this occasion is Kenny Ozevich of Berkeley. Here are the Red Wings in. Kozlov the shot, and that just missed. It was goaltender interference.
Did he ever rip it right over the shoulder and beside the right ear of Jimmy Waite? Kozlov with a snapshot, boy, and a dandy. Whew. Boy, look at this thing. A bad angle, nowhere to go. He might even banked it off his right shoulder because this faceoff is staying inside. That had to hit the goaltender or it comes out over the blue line. Because he's got the sights set high, and he's got one already to show for it.
Well, Jimmy Waite started the season at 6-0-3. And since then, he's gone 0-4-1. He struggled, spent some time in Springfield on a conditioning stint. Nikolai Habibulin had just been so tired that Robert S. started the other night against Boston. Habibulin was to go tonight, but he injured a groin, so Jimmy Waite just back up gets the start. Red Wing power play to test him now. Eisenman played in behind the goal. Kozlov out far side, got it back from Larionov. Eisenman goes to the point. Picked up by Keith Kearney, and he'll send it down the ice. Mike Stapleton up number 14 on the forecheck, the Sarnia native for Phoenix. Lidstrom, he'll carry out for the Red Wings. A pass on to the tape of Kozlov. He'll send it through. Stapleton over there to pick it up, and he'll send it right back. Osgood, he'll play quarterback. Got it ahead to Kozlov, who has his 18th goal of the season tonight. Lidstrom's pass hit the skate of Tkachuk. And Keith Tkachuk with his 23rd goal, a team lead, nearly stole one there. And his 9th on the power play. Here goes Roenick to Tkachuk. Oh. What a save! Oh, Osgood! In rapier-like fashion gets that left hand out to Stona.
Unbelievable, that stop on a bullet blast by Tkachuk. Rings having all kinds of problems handling the puck inside their own line. Roenick steals, sets up for a one-timer on Tkachuk. And Osgood absolutely picked his pocket. What a save that was. Holy mackerel.
Boy.
Right to the hash mark.
that Chuck had won earlier. Just two goals, his last 11 coming into play tonight. Nearly at his second, but for Chris Osgood.
He wanted that one big time. He's going, I can't believe he stopped that.
Oh, the kick. Coyotes captain, the Melrose, Massachusetts native, who'd been slumping a bit of late after a great start, but he's really had to fight through injuries this season. He's missed 14 games due to injury. But tonight appears to be on fire, and Osgood red hot. Giveaway inside deep as Klima had coughed it up. Now turning back goes Holmstrom. Less than a half minute to go in the Red Wing power play. Fed ahead to Shanahan, catching up Klima. Holmstrom to the net. The pass to Holmstrom, too well covered. Chop to the line. Good play. Murphy to hold in. Knockdown. Brown the shot. Save weight. Rebound and just knocked wide of the goal. Holmstrom in there digging for it. Nice stop by Klima. Given away by Klima.
Wow.
Who took it right back.
That's offside. That'll be called. Boy, oh boy. She's a free-for-all right now, boy.
And that faceoff coming all the way back into the Red Wing zone. If you want to find out what the Red Wings are really like, and if you want to see what they do when they're away from the game, then we've got the show for you. Watch Ray and Mickey on Ice, a new show premiering Sunday, March 14th. I'll even pop in from time to time. It's unlike anything else on television. With these two, it's guaranteed to be fun. Ray and Mickey on Ice premieres Sunday night, March 14th at 11, right after STV, only on UPN 50. Don't miss it. Jim Schoenfeld in his 10th season as National Hockey League coach, the former Detroit Red Wing from 81 through 83, played 96 games also with Buffalo and Boston, and here's the last stop.
That's maybe Jimmy White's best stop right there. I don't know if he saw it or not, went down low, got the pads on it. You can bet the Red Wings, part of their game plan, if they can do it, is to get up, because White looks like he likes to go down. There's a big hit by Tockett on Ward.
Threw in the elbow on Ward. Tockett with it in front. Puck is knocked down and carried out by Maltby.
There's a penalty to Tockett now. Holy smoke. Maltby. Or is it going to be Maltby?
Well, Maltby was whacked.
Yeah, he was. And here's McCarty now.
Maltby.
Having words with one of the Coyotes. I can't tell who that is, but I think it's going to be a Tockett penalty for a slash on Maltby, who's stinging.
Seemed to get it in a spot where you don't want to be hit.
And McCarty and Gagnon are having words. You can bet that those two are going to have a little conversation before this one's over.
Really fine.
Well, about the halfway point of the first period, this is quite a free-for-all going on here. Lots of hitting. Tockett and Ward down behind Osgood. They went up the other end of the ice after this opportunity, and Osgood put the lumber to Kurt Maltby just past center ice. Right there. See, he speared him in the groin. That's what he did. And Maltby stinging on that one, and shorthanded go the Coyotes again. Boy, they are playing rough and tumble hockey, Kenny boy.
Well, they've lost eight of their past nine games, and they're trying to get it back on track. Yzerman. Kozlov slapped it around. Larionov to Lidstrom to Yzerman. The shot. Scores! Yzerman let it rip. A power play goal. It's 2-1.
Didn't take them long. 13 seconds. It looks like Jimmy Waite is struggling on that goal. He kind of, I know Yzerman got lots on it, but he kind of just flopped to the right. He didn't look right at all in trying to make that save. Nice setup by Lidstrom. Perfectly timed and with the right amount of zip on it for a one-timer. Larionov to Lidstrom to Yzerman for, look at Waite. He's kind of guessing. He just kind of missed it. And Yzerman continues to play well and puts his team up 2-1, and Phoenix pays the price.
And that makes a Bell Tire power play winner for George Millen of Royal Oak, as Steve Yzerman one times one home on the Bell Tire power play. And with that, it's 2-1. And Steve Yzerman gets his 25th goal of the season, and that, Mickey, passes last season's total of 24. And with that, he also moves past Stan Mikita. All alone in 10th spot in National Hockey League scoring. Or in the 9th place. Sent back out.
Yzerman's getting run at twice now, and he's used that stick to protect himself.
That'll be offside. Eisenman from Lidstrom and Larry on up. The power play goal makes it 2-1. Maltby, who wound up putting the wings on that power play thanks to the Tocket slash. And Phoenix penalty killing has been pretty good, second in the league. But here the Red Wings get the power play goal, 6 for their last 25 now. As Steve Yzerman scores his 25th of the season and his 11th on the power play. So the Red Wings, for the second time in this game, have bolted into the lead. Up 2-1. .588 career goal for the captain. As he gets closer and closer to the magical 600 mark. Just 12 away now. Knocked down at center ice. Red Wings on that puck. Have lots of jump tonight. Here come the Coyotes. Cummins. His shot deflected to the corner. Dearborn, Michigan native Cummins back of the goal. Phoenix holding it in. Turning with it is Carney. Back to the point. Held in by Stephen Leach, the man who began the season with the Senators, picked up by Phoenix, and with all their injuries has been in the lineup. Murphy at center. He'll dump it into the Coyotes zone as the Red Wings and Phoenix both change. Approaching the halfway point of the opening period. Phoenix has outshot Detroit 10-4, but it's the Red Wings up where it counts by one. Draper, he's speeding away ahead with Holmstrom. Draper in the shot, and he missed the net.
No stick for the defenseman. That was just like a two-on-one. Dabrowski.
Holmstrom will shoot it in off the high glass. Took a good bounce to Draper. Squeezed out of the play. Carries on with McCarty and Holmstrom. Knocked down by Dabrowski. Holmstrom gets back up. Swept it through. Tkachuk can't clear. Staying with Dandino. Good play by Matthew Dandino to hold it in the zone. Dallas Drake. Spin around the move inside the line, and a penalty coming up to Holmstrom for knocking down Dallas Drake.
Yeah, Drake going after Holmstrom. And this is not what Dallas Drake wants to do. As far as his team's concerned, I mean, not good thinking by Dallas here. He may be lucky he didn't get another penalty and, you know, even this thing out, but boy, that's not what you want to do. I mean, it's one thing to be ready to play and have your intensity level up good and high, but boy, you've got to control that temper in the right situations. And Drake really upset with Holmstrom, and it's Holmstrom who's getting the penalty for holding. So all kinds of penalties here in the first period. Lots of hitting. 3 goals already. Red Wings have 2, but Phoenix goes back to the power play in their last one. Osgood got knocked down by Roenick. No penalty call, and Tkachuk ends up scoring the goal. 2-1 Detroit lead. You're going to see what Drake took exception to that when they were getting up, see?
Coyotes 1-for-1 on the power play, scored in their only shot, 43 seconds into their power play try. There's a look at the former Red Wing, Dallas Drake, former 116th overall pick in 89 by Detroit. Christine Hobart of Garden City, our Mishcon shorthanded challenger. If the Wings score during the penalty kill, Christine Hobart will win $50 in Red Wing merchandise. Phoenix holding fourth seed in the West. But the Ducks, the Wings' next opponent, are just 5 points in arrears. The Wings using their game in hand tonight on Colorado. Detroit just 2 points back of the Avalanche, thanks to Tampa Bay's win last night for second seed in the West. So a lot at stake here tonight. Playoffs not far away. Roenick knocked it down. Tkachuk moved it to the point to Darren Quint, the defenseman who's been up on forward, what with all the Coyote injuries, but he's manning the point now. Boy, do they miss Jyrki Lumi out.
Oh, boy, you're not kidding, especially offensively and on his power play.
Didick hurt too. Here's Tkachuk. fed through to Daniel Briere, who helped set up Tkachuk in the first Phoenix power play try. As we mentioned, second worst power play in the league and worst in the National Hockey League. At home are the Coyotes. They're now four for their last 47 tries. That's operating under 7%.
It's hard to believe with guys like Tkachuk and Roenick and Tvardovsky and Lume, who's there for most of that. But when you're cold, boy. That's just the way it is. You just got to keep working through it. Tocchet, he's having a great year with 22 to match his number.
Brought forward by Numanen. Across for Oleg Tvardovsky. Off Tocchet, wide of the goal. Dallas Drake, number 11. Back to the line. Knocked down by Lidstrom, who stayed with Stapleton. Drake off Stapleton's stick. Murphy staying with him, rubbed him out of the play. Lidstrom took a bit of a high stick. High slot, the shot, and Osgood will hang on as Teppo Numanen let it go.
Boy, these guys flood the front of the net, don't they? They slam and bang in the corners and go to the front, boy. I mean, if this Phoenix team doesn't put themselves in trouble with penalties, they're tough to play against. Tocchet had his stick right up in front of Osgood's eyes. But they're big and strong and tough, and they're hard to play against. And you come out of a game with the Phoenix Coyotes or a series with lots of bumps and bruises, boy.
There is number 22, the hard-nosed Rick Tocchet, who scored his 400th NHL goal in January. One of two players in NHL history with 400 plus goals and 2,000 penalty minutes. The only other man to do that, Pat Verbeek. Tocchet comes to play every night. Phoenix power play winding down, and it'll end here as Larionov shoots it ahead. Holmstrom out of the box, pass too far for him. Icing is indicated. Back to touch is Keith Carney, the former Sabre and Blackhawk, and the faceoff will come back into the Red Wings zone. 7:19 to go in the first. 2-1 Red Wings on UPN 50. Well, plenty of Red Wing fans here in Phoenix. Want to wish a happy 70th birthday to Mary Olson of Madison Heights from her son Kirk. She's a big Red Wing and Mickey Redmond fan. Who isn't? Happy 8th birthday on Monday to Willie Spears. And a big hello to a big Red Wing fan, Jenny Skotak from Southgate. 7:10 to go here in the opening period. 2-1, the Red Wings leading the Phoenix Coyotes. Haven't these two clubs developed a great rivalry? Dandenault knocked down on the play. Look back to Van Lassenhove.
Yeah, he was looking for a penalty for sure.
Carney to Bob Corkum, who early on this season was a favorite for the Selke Trophy. Great defensive effort. Since then, though, the Coyotes have slid back a touch. Pass off Scott Kozlov's skate. This will still be icing, but no, it won't. His weight came out to play it. Send it up the near boards. Kozlov there to steal, and he'll send it right back in. Oh, what? Hit Tvardovsky on the way through. Gagnon just got it up. At center ice, stepped into was Tavis Hansen, another rookie, number 47 for Phoenix. That Pittsburgh game on the road trip a while back, Coyotes so beat up, they had six players called up from Springfield in their lineup that night.
And yet they're a heck of a lot less man injuries. They only got around 150 or so. Last year they were over 400.
Shot through is knocked down, and through all that, finished just above 500 thanks to going 9-3 their last dozen games, Phoenix did, to gain a playoff berth. Terrific down the stretch. Here they were terrific early on. This campaign beginning 17-3-3, but since then have fallen back quite a ways. Osgood flexing to make that save. Puck going off to the corner for Hansen.
Lebowski's first shift out there.
Puck is intercepted, knocked down, a race for it. Draper's away, Red Wings changing. Draper ridden hard into the boards by Darren Quint. Numanen got it to center. Riccardi's shooting attempt hit a stanchion. Overskating the puck was Tkachuk. They got all crossed up. And McCarty will send it into the Coyote zone. Draper hit Numanen. Tkachuk the Phoenix captain. Two-time 50 goal back-to-back drop Peronik into the thought. Puck is knocked down. As the Coyotes came close again, Brown left it there for Ward. Aaron Ward knocked down by Jabrodowski. That could have been a penalty.
Well, I think he's called too many in a row, or these last two would have been called. On Phoenix.
Drake can't get through. Stopped ahead, Aaron Ward, another chance. Klima going to the net. Ward taken out of the play. And the Coyotes get it to neutral ice. Turning the speedy Dandenham. Intercepted by Jeremy Roenick. Cummins, drop back. Shot just wide of the goal by Shane Doan, number 19. Cummins is on it. His backhand shot went wide as he broke his stick. Shane Doan behind the net. Doan tied up by Aaron Ward. Good job by Ward not to grab him too much, or there would have been a penalty. Dandenault, long shot, hit a leg. Quick turnover at center ice, Phoenix. Jabrodowski will shoot it through. Coyotes change, Dandenault with it. He'll clear the zone and out to center ice. Sent right back in, Nick Lidstrom. To Slava Kozlov, who opened the scoring here tonight. Goes looking for the return feed. Larionov from his skate to his stick to Kozlov. Just can't cut through. Drop for Larionov. Into the high slot. Puck is knocked down on the back check by Tocchet. Stapleton back for Tocchet. Punched into the Red Wings zone. Briere going after it. Osgood will shoot it around. Kozlov left it there. Coyotes Briere behind the net. He has had a couple of concussions this season, Danielle Briere.
Two on one.
Here's Larionov with Lapointe. Larionov taken out. Stapleton will turn it back. Murphy to intercept. Good play by Larionov to close it off at center ice. Jamie McCowan, who was rested that last game against the Islanders, back in the lineup tonight in place of Anders Ericsson. Shanahan. He'll flip it through. Wait leaving it. 2:30 to go. Opening period. 2-1 Red Wing lead. Phoenix has outshot Detroit 13-5. A steal in front. Deflected high over top of the goal. Clear down the ice. This will be icing against Phoenix as Dandenault is back to touch. We've seen it go from end to end. We've seen plenty of hits and some good scoring opportunities. A bit of everything for you on a Friday night from Phoenix on UPN 50. Plenty of Red Wing fans in the crowd here in Phoenix. Marcia Boykin, Michelle Delsch from the Red Wing Forum Club. Want to say hi to friends and family back in Detroit. Happy birthday wishes to Roy Skaggs and Bill Ogilvy. Off the draw. Multi shot. Went wide. Picked up by Tavis Hansen, number 47. Phoenix will send it in. Osgood off the glass up high. Shane Doan. McCowan won't let him get through. Held in by Corkum. Knocked down to Doan. Puck still free in there. Doan whacking at it. Hansen came up with it. Osgood to stop as Tavis Hansen had a good opportunity. Boy, the Phoenix Coyotes made something out of nothing.
Sure did. Pretty good work right there by Hansen. This is going to be icing right on the net.
Harney tied up by Maltby, got it around behind the goal. Shane Doan in his own slot will carry out, had nowhere to go, tipped it to the Red Wing line. Murphy to intercept to McCarty. Can't knock it down. Holmstrom up there quickly. Kachuk brought it back inside his own line and accelerates through center the other way. Keith Kachuk trying to split the seam, he couldn't. Sent ahead for Holmstrom, up with the speedy Draper, left wing side. Draper into the corner. Left it there for Holmstrom. Back behind the goal the other way for McCarty. Van Massenhoven getting out of the way. Lidstrom, good job in his backhand to hold in, then had it go off a leg and ricochet to center. Lidstrom ahead to Holmstrom. Return feed to his countryman, now to Murphy. Maltby will go after it. Darren Quint there first. He'll send it back to the Red Wing line. Murphy waiting. hit Dallas Drake with his outlet. He'll get it back. 20 seconds left here in the opening period. Just dumped in as LaPointe sends it through. Red Wings will be quite content to take a 2-1 lead to their dressing room, outshot 14-6. But really, the Red Wings have applied some pressure as well, and the Coyote fans, with time winding down, aren't that pleased. But a strong Red Wing contingent here tonight in Phoenix, as always, they're pretty happy with a 2-1 lead after 20 minutes of play.
Well, some guys got a lot of ice time, like Aaron Ward again, and did a nice job late in the period on Tkachuk driving for the net. A rough and tumble first period, but the Coyotes trying to tie it up. That's a nice job by Ward to stay with the big gunner and keep it 2-1 Detroit. Good period of hockey, and boy, no place for a nervous person. A lot of hitting going on here, mostly by Phoenix.
So it is 2-1, the Red Wings leading Phoenix after 20 minutes of play. We're back in a moment to the desert on UPN 50.
Peter Klima here, and Peter, good chance to have a chat with you anyway on your return, but I'll bet the fourth game for you now.
Yeah, it's I've been hurt for 10 days, and I just got out there on the power play, the puck just bouncing around, and a little bit nervous. I just got to get used to playing on the point again, and just find the guys out there.
All right, you talk about nervousness. No matter how long you've been in this league, the nerves do figure in here a little bit, right?
Well, when you don't play for 2 years and then come in the best team in the world, so it's you get to get a little bit nervous, but I get over it, and hopefully the second period I get better.
And a short sketch on Phoenix. Would you call this team an aggressive and maybe slightly dirty team?
Yeah, well, they just play home, good home game. They are aggressive team. They take in the body, and you got to get used to this, and just play our game.
Peter, nice to have you here. Stay with us, buddy, and stay healthy.
Thank you very much.
Peter Klima, back with the Red Wings. Folks, by the way, we have a chance right now. I'd like to say hello to Lydia Kontich, who is recovering in the Beaumont Hospital on Royal Oak. Lydia, Red Wings say hi and get well soon. 2-1, Red Wings leading after the first period of play, and we're coming right back to Phoenix, so don't go away.
Ken Daniels, Mickey Redmond, and Ray Lane, our executive producer Toby Cunningham, back here in Phoenix. As we get set to start second period. Fans, make your home into a hockey town home with the new Red Wings Hockey Town Home Collection. Get your official one-of-a-kind Red Wings furniture, including a Red Wings bar, bed, desk, glass tables, and more. Stop by the Joe Louis Arena Pro Shop or call 1-800-WINGS-25 to order your Red Wings furniture items today. It's a pretty snazzy-looking bar. You seen that?
I have.
Pretty neat.
Yes, indeed.
I'm making sure my son doesn't see the bed, though.
Yeah,
he'll want that in a heartbeat.
Absolutely, yeah. It's pretty snazzy stuff.
Sure is. Second period now underway. Lidstrom sent it out to center. It was knocked down by Tkachuk, and the captain, Yzerman, who scored his 25th of the season here tonight. Now ninth all-time scoring ahead of Stan Mikita. Can't get into the Coyote zone. Slap back, Yzerman goes after it. Played more than 8 minutes the opening period. Put on the brakes, and Jimmy Waite made the save. Well, Yzerman's made that move a lot of late, and it's working more often than not. Just stopping short. Here's Roenick. High slot. Shot hit a leg. Drake behind the goal. Roenick tied up back there. Tkachuk goes in to steal. Sent it back. Intercepted. And brought out smartly.
Good move.
Draper into the zone. Dropped it back. Pulse from the shot, wait to save, the rebound, and cleared. Jan Golubovsky retreats. To Aaron Ward. Up to Holmstrom. He'll clear it to an open wing. Phoenix changing. Daigneault sent one across. Knocked back, McCarty can't get it through to Draper. He's offside, and our first stop and play, 1:19 into period number two.
Now the Phoenix Coyotes had a very physical first period, and some of their
folks saying that this is the first time they've seen the team play like that in a long, long time. They've had a pretty tough period the last couple of months, but Detroit seems to bring the best out of these Coyotes. They beat Detroit twice this year. Pretty handily back in Detroit a month ago.
That was 6-2 on December 22nd. At that time, Phoenix was 19-5-4. Since that win over the Red Wings, December 22nd, Phoenix six games under 500, 10-16-6. So they've dropped quite a bit. They've lost 8 of their past 9. This is the first game back after that 7-game road trip. And they sometimes say the first game back home is the toughest to play after a while away.
It didn't look like it in that first period. They had lots of energy and sometimes too much and took 3 penalties. Red Wings made them pay on the Yzerman goal.
And ironically, the first team the Red Wings will meet after their 5-game road trip back at the Joe on St. Patrick's Day will be Phoenix. So a similar circumstance. Tockett toward the goal. Osgood came out to play it around to Holmstrom. He'll whack at it. Getting over Briere to hold it in. Kicked at by Draper.
Let's go, let's go.
Briere squeezing through. He's diminutive. Back to the point. Stapleton shot. Got through and Osgood will hang on.
Yeah, you were talking a moment ago about Yzerman with that patented move of his where he goes to the outside, stops, and pulls it back to the middle to try to get himself a better angle for a scoring chance. Teppo Numminen played it pretty well on that one, but Wade again was forced to make a save.
Phoenix has pumped 15 shots at Chris Osgood.
Boy, can shots be misleading. Look at the Maple Leafs last night. 9 shots on goal in St. Louis, and they win 4-0. Boy. Mind you, the Blues are, their goaltending is decimated.
Yeah, they've signed Jim Carrey, the Blues have, to try and beef it up in the absence of Fuhrer. Rich Perrault injured. They're chasing Detroit for first in the division. Detroit has their sights set, though, on second overall in the conference to try and finish ahead of Colorado. Colorado without Fleury for who knows how long. May have him back when they meet the Red Wings a week from Sunday, not sure. And Pavel Bure out for at least 3 weeks in Florida. 2 key players hurt for their respective clubs. Drop back to Kozlov and just out of his reach onside. Or Tkachuk offside.
Well, he lets it go.
There to get a penalty coming up.
Boy, oh boy. Tkachuk is pleading innocent. Now, whether he intended to knock down McCowan or not, we'll have to take a look at it later on. But a smart way to let it go. Yes, he did. The body language is there. Not a good penalty for the captain to take.
Would you the Tkachuk penalty as we went to break, dumping McCowan in the box for interference at 3:10. So he made the right play not to touch to let Roenick go in after it, but then he made the bad play on the penalty. So we go to our Bell Tire power play. Our partner this time, Fred Slabiak of Oak Park. Red Wings have had 4:13 of power play time. 4:13. They're 1-for-3. Yzerman getting the power play goal. Shanahan in the corner. Holmstrom swept it back to Murphy. On to Lidstrom. Back for Murphy. Murphy, the shot. Scores! Did Shanahan tip it in front?
I believe he did.
I think he did too. 2 power play goals. It's 3-1.
That took just 27 seconds. Yzerman's took 13. And Holmstrom was scarily close to the top of the crease on this one. Wow. But nice give and go by Murphy. Yeah, Shanahan just got the tip of the blade on it. And it gets by Jimmy Wade on the catching glove side. He never saw it.
And Holmstrom stayed out, Nick. He's on the periphery, but not on the line.
Yep, just outside, so he's learning well. And Detroit has a 2-goal lead. The experience and the smarts of Lidstrom and Murphy made that one all possible. And Shanahan makes it 3-1.
And I'll tell you what, I believe that's Brendan Shanahan's first power play goal in 38 road games. Going back to last season, did not have one. Gets one here on the power play. That's just his third with the man advantage. Now has 6 goals his past 15 games, though. His 23rd of the season gives the Red Wings a 3-1 lead.
Now, Phoenix, if Phoenix can have a chance in this hockey game, they have got to get their emotions under control. I mean, they're taking some bad penalties. Detroit's got 2 power play goals. And you just can't play that way and expect to win.
Red Wings, who went 0-for-5 their last outing versus the Islanders on the power play, are 2-for-4 here tonight. Shanahan from Murphy and Lidstrom, a power play goal. That's offside. And the Coyotes this season, when they trail by 2 goals, are 0-17-0. They've lost all 17, have not won a game, Jim Schoenfeld's team, when they're down by 2, and they're down by 2 here.
Well, with that, I'll give you a happy birthday to, it looks like, Daryl Smith of Grand Blanc, Michigan. And his son, Matt, who's at the game tonight, and from Traverse City, Kevin Clark wanted us to say hello to all the folks down here. He's down here for a little sun and work. And did you see all that beef jerky and turkey stuff that came up here for you? Chuck and Gail Middlestad of Irons, Michigan. All that good stuff. You'll be in it on the plane tonight on the way to Anaheim.
I guess I will.
And I got to sit there and watch it.
I'm sorry.
Let's go right to it. Have a good time.
What a play by Lidstrom to hold that puck in. Now Shanahan, the latest goal scorer for the Red Wings. Held it in. Eisenman, who has one. Comes out all alone.
Yes.
Scores! Makes it 4-1, his second of the night. The Red Wings are rolling.
Well, Phoenix makes a mistake of standing and watching, and Schoenfeld knows it. They're on their heels now. And I'm not sure, did Shanahan bank that off?
He did.
I think Shanahan got a piece of that, and it went off the post. Eisenman to Shanahan, off the goal post, trickles over the line. Jimmy Waite's getting a hook. Boy, oh boy. And it's 4-1 Red Wings.
So is this Scott Lankow just called up? His first game. Jimmy Waite, as you mentioned, had just been called up. He'd been on a conditioning stint in Springfield. Been so good early on this season. Started out at 6-0-3, struggled since. Nikolai Habibulin out with a groin injury. And Scott Lankow, after the Red Wings scored 4 goals on 10 shots on Jimmy Waite, Scott Lankow takes over. Steve Yzerman helping set up Brendan Shanahan for his second goal of the evening. Shanahan now with 24, one shy of Yzerman's team lead. So what a play by the captain.
Phoenix just stood there and let him come out in front. That was a mistake. You just can't give him that kind of room.
And then didn't tie up Shanahan's stick on the feed as Osgood hangs on.
Now, there was 2 Red Wings in front, 3 Coyotes there. 3 of them took the 2, left Yzerman alone, and then they didn't take Shanahan that well, and they pay the price again. So they're on their heels. Their confidence is very low.
Shanahan from Yzerman and Maltby, the scoring play.
Let me take a look at it from an overhead view. Now watch. It's Gagnon. He goes out to meet Shanahan, but he lets him get by, and that allows Yzerman to come right out around the side of the net to the right of Waite. There's no chance for Jimmy Waite.
And you know who let Yzerman go? Andrei Vasiliev, just called up from the minors due to the injury to Greg Adams. He only got here about 20 minutes before the game started. And that was perhaps his first shift of the game. Hadn't seen Vasiliev earlier. Let Shanahan go. Yes, it was. Did not play in the first period. So his first shift, first time up. And beaten to the puck, and it's a goal that puts the Red Wings up by 3. 2 goals in 55 seconds for Detroit. Draper's good speed negated the icing. Holmstrom in on it. Holmstrom, good work up front, and just through the crease. Has a good chance for Darren McCarty. Tkachuk will carry out to Drake. Back for Tkachuk. Up with Roenick. Tkachuk on Ward. Can't get past. Into Numanen. Draper, first man there. He'll wrap it to the line. Teberdovsky held in. Tkachuk the shot. Deflected wide of the goal. Drake will wrap it off the boards to Roenick. Tied up by Ward. That's Carney. played it behind the goal. Now out front, Roenick back for Teberdovsky. Blocked. Good play by Darren McCarty to get it back down the ice. Teberdovsky trying to wheel around Kozlov toward the goal. Osgood made the save. We mentioned that Phoenix had lost 8 of their last 9 coming into this one tonight as Carney brings it through and a penalty coming up. And as Detroit touches, the Red Wings will be shorthanded. LaPointe will be going off. As LaPointe has a hold of Carney with the hook. Maybe Carney helped it out a bit. But talked about Phoenix losing 8 of their last 9. And of those 9 games, Mick, Phoenix had scored just 11 goals. So they're not scoring much, and they allowed 35.
Yeah,
they outscored 35 to 11 their last 9 games.
Far cry from when they went 17 straight games earlier in the year, allowing 2 goals or less. But it's a long season. You can't be that high all the time and that productive. So they're just hoping that they can, you know, get this funk out of the way and get it turned around. Because let's face it, there's still lots of time left in the season before the playoffs start. 7 weeks, 6 weeks, really.
Mishkon shorthanded challenger Sue Moulton of Clinton Township will win $50 in Red Wing merchandise if the Wings score during this Mishkon shorthanded challenge. Roenick and the captain. Coyotes control. Darren Quint to Roenick. Had to knock it down. Bouncing puck stripped from him. And sent down the ice by Steve Eisen. Maltby up on Newman, who will leave it for Darren Quint, number 5. He's been playing a lot more frequently with the injury to Adams and playing up front here, manning the point. Osgood ran into trouble. Slapped around Breer. Steals it front. A shot over top of the goal. Sent high by Darren Quint. Back to Newman. Intercepted by Eisenman. Coyotes still control. Kachuk to Quint. The shot, the deflection, the rebound, the save. Knocked down by Roenick.
5-on-3. No stick, Maltby.
Great chance here for Phoenix as Newman has it again. Getting it back. Roenick, high spot. Kachuk scores! Breer on the deflection, I believe. Play goal, their second of the night. They're within 2.
Well, they work it to the hash mark. To Kachuk. Set it up in a split second and let it go. A bang bang play. Now that hit Murphy's stick for sure. Whether it got Breer or not, we'll have to wait and see. But it did change directions on Chris Osgood, and it's 4-2. Here's Breer, number 8, parked in front of the net. He's in the creek. Oh boy, he just barely got out of the way. And it didn't look like in that replay that it touched him, but he'll be happy to make it 4-2, and I think it's going to be Kachuk the second of the night.
Kachuk had just 8 goals his past 40 games coming into play tonight. If he gets that one, it will be his 24th of the season and his 10th on the power play.
Coyotes goal, a power play goal.
So Phoenix within a couple.
24th on the year.
Stacey Roost out there. Kachuk does get it. So he'll hit a Red Wing stick, not Breer's. Roenick picking up one assist, and Teppo Newman getting the other. The 300th career assist for Teppo Newman. 716, the power play goal. So the Red Wings have 2 on a power play. Phoenix has both of theirs on the power play. The Red Wings are offside. It's 4-2 Detroit. With 12:07 to go in the second period, Kachuk draws them within a pair. So Steve Eisenman helps set up Brendan Shanahan to give the Red Wings a 4-1 lead. Kachuk has narrowed it to 4-2. Shanahan getting those 2 goals in a span of 55 seconds. But it's now 4-2. Puck sent ahead, fired in by Darren McCarty out there along with Draper and Holmstrom, who has it. Holmstrom to Draper, moving in Golubovsky. McCarty behind the goal, looks out for Draper, too well covered. Dropped forward by Tockett. Bouncing puck, Osgood the stop, the rebound, and he'll hang on to a bouncing puck. Doing some strange things close to the goal.
Draper, McCarty, and Holmstrom are holding their breath on that one. The three of them were all in tight to the Phoenix net. The next thing you know, Phoenix got a 4-on-2 break. And Draper continues to jaw with Tockett. As Draper ran at him, nothing serious. He just hit him with the shoulder. And I mean, if there was anything dirty in the play, but Tockett didn't like it, and he's continuing to give it to Draper. I can only imagine, without reading his lips, he's saying, I'll talk to you later, and maybe it won't be talk.
Well, there is Chris Draper using his speed tonight. As you can see, the Red Wings, when they score four, have not lost. Deflected, and Osgood had to be quick. And when the Coyotes allow three or more often than not, they don't win. But you could say that for many teams in the National Hockey League. Quint. Turned back by two-goal scorer Shanahan. Here's Shane Doan. And Osgood will hang on to that.
The Red Wings would like to make it difficult here for Phoenix to get a whole lot going, but I mean, there's so much energy in this building, and inside of the penalties that Phoenix has taken, I mean, they've played a good physical game and they've pressed the front of the net, getting themselves in trouble, and Detroit has two power play goals, and that is the difference in this hockey game right now.
Roenick, Tkachuk, and Drake, the forward unit, has been dangerous all night for Phoenix. They don't drop it in yet. Will they wind up out of the circle? Now we'll talk to Steve Yzerman. Well, we have a moment. Want to wish David Wood a happy 11th birthday. Don and Val Johnson of Kalkaskin are here tonight in Phoenix celebrating their 44th anniversary together. Seeing the Red Wings in a two-goal lead, approaching the halfway point of this hockey game. Sent ahead to Maltby, a two-on-one with Shanahan. Maltby in the shot, big save, rebound, and knocked down as Shanahan was going for the hat trick. Here's Drake into Roenick and offside.
I think that shot, the backhand shot by Shanahan, hit the defenseman Quint with a wide open net. And Maltby elected to go to the net in a two-on-one. The defenseman really let him go. And he wound up and ripped it, and the puck bounces off of Quint after Shanahan got a chip shot backhander. And that never got to the net.
Shanahan with two goals tonight, giving him 24. He had 28 last season when he led the team in goals, power play goals, game-winning goals, and shots. And up there again this season in all but the power play goal department. Doan going in there after it. Along with Vasiliev, number 44 for Phoenix. The Red Wings bring it through. Hooked his Larionov. Trailing. Kozlov got it to the point. Around behind the goal for J.J. Daniel. Picked up from Nashville. More or less to complete the deal, it was Daniel for Cliff Ronning, and couldn't the Coyotes, who have had a lack of scoring of late, use Cliff Ronning, who's doing so well now for Nashville, but the Coyotes had to clear off a salary of $1.5 million. Here's a stolen puck, and three Red Wings are up.
Brought down, Kozlov looks across. Oh. Scores! Dandino! What a pass and what a goal!
Bingo!
It's 5-2!
Oh, that was... I'm going to tell you that right now, that's a goal that looks like a championship team. I mean, that's perfect execution, speed, finesse, skill, smarts, and the ability to finish. A perfect pass by Kozlov. One time, no handle the puck by Dandino. Absolutely no chance for the goaltender. That was nicely done.
Look at the delay here by Kozlov, just till the stick came over.
He forced the defenseman to bring that stick across out of the way and then dumped it in front of him. Watch him bring it over. When he went this way, puck goes this way. No chance for the goaler. That was nicely done.
Dandino jumps up, gets himself a goal, his third of the campaign, using his speed to join the rush.
Unbelievable.
It's 5-2. Phoenix had gained some life on that Tkachuk power play goal, and the Red Wings took it away. Tocchet gets bumped immediately by Aaron Ward. 10:30, the time of the goal. Slava Kozlov picking up the lone assist. What a pretty one it was. Kozlov had opened the scoring with his 18th of the season here. 1:10 into the game. Aaron Quint almost had his pocket picked by Klima. To the line, held in by Gagnon. Good work by Rich to move it ahead. A break for Brown. In alone. Southlake, a rebound. And Klima couldn't finish. Big stop by Scott Lankow. Boy, the Red Wings. That transition game working better than it has in months here tonight. Finding the seams and splitting them. Gagnon played ahead and flipped in. Dandino made it 5-2, goes back. Gets bumped immediately by Stephen Leach, number 23. Jim Cummins, the former wing. Leach behind the goal. Cowan tapped it away. Taken by Corkum. Sent in front. Oh! And out the other side. As Osgood had sprawled across. Holmstrom will shoot it through. 7:45 to go, second period. The Red Wings lead it 5-2. Here's a break in. And Rowan couldn't finish. Had Osgood down and out.
That'll be a nice thing. Osgood may have gotten a poke check or the big sweep check on Roenick, who has complained to Van Massenhoven. He gets a great scoring chance, but Osgood outguessed him. And we will take a break. It's really hot in Phoenix, and not just outside. Now watch Osgood with the poke check on Roenick. Well, I don't know if he got a piece of it out in front of the top of our screen or not, but enough to throw Roenick off that he couldn't get his stick back on the puck with the open net, so it remains 5-2.
Here's Newman. Shot went wide of the goal, and Osgood will grab hold of this one. The Red Wings have had some big contributions here tonight in front of Chris Osgood. They've been outshot 26-15, so Osgood's had most of the work here tonight. The Red Wings have scored 5 goals on 15 shots. Brendan Shanahan with 2 goals. Nick Lidstrom, 2 assists. Igor Larionov, 2 assists. Yzerman, 1 goal, 1 assist. Slava Kozlov with a goal and an assist. Lidstrom sets up. Cross for Murphy. Flipped ahead. Drake there to intercept. Lidstrom will move it up to Shanahan. Brendan Shanahan had a hat trick in the home opener this season on the banner night when they raised the 97-98 Stanley Cup banner. Shanahan scored 3 against his former club, the St. Louis Blues, that night when he got off to such a great start, and has 2 here tonight, and nearly had another but for it to be blocked.
about 5 minutes ago.
Now that goal has taken some steam out of the crowd that was on the Phoenix side. About half this crowd is a Red Wing crowd again. A lot of transplanted Michiganders down here in the desert. And a lot of come in for the game. So there are Red Wing jerseys all over this building.
And there's a referendum to take place in about a month or so on whether there will be a new building built, some with taxpayer money, or whether they renovate this building. There's about 4,000 obstructed seats at one end that you can't see from about center ice in. And there may be renovations in order if, in fact, there is not a new building to be built, which they'd like to have done for play here in about 3 years. But they've really taken a hockey here in the desert. A great building this is. America West Arena, a loud building. The only bad part is those obstructed seats at the end where Chris Osgood's at this period. Tockett. Turn back by Igor Larionov. Now it goes to Carney. Good acquisition by the Coyotes. Keith Carney has been to an open wing. Lapointe goes after it. His shot! And Lenkow stopped it, then couldn't find it. Shane Doan. Fed it off to his right. Now goes to the net. McCowan intercepted. Tverdovsky stayed with it, but Roos whacked it out. Here goes Klima in a race. Klima with Doan will get there first. Klima, the shot is blocked. As Gagnon got in front of him. Here's Golubovsky. His shot. That hit Brown going to the front of the net. Roos behind the goal. Tverdovsky will take it out. The speedy old leg, Tverdovsky to center. Had nowhere to go, and that's offside. Well, do you want exclusive interviews, photos, and the inside story on your favorite Red Wings? You can't miss with the official magazine of the Detroit Red Wings, Inside Hockey Town. Subscribe now, and you'll get 7 exciting issues delivered right to your door for only $28. To order your Inside Hockey Town subscription, call 313-396-7575 during regular business hours.
Now, Steve Yzerman had gone off to get some equipment repairs. He now returns from the Red Wing dressing room. Takes his spot on the end of the bench. Well, Boyer had gone off with him and has stayed there. So with only 5 and change left here in the period, he's probably going to just stay in the dressing room area.
Here goes Draper. Rebound. Hopped over his stick off the Lenkow. First save. Cummins will send it into the Red Wing zone.
And Detroit Kenny's really lining up now. The worst you see is a 2-3 defensively, and sometimes a 1-4 like this right here. There's just nowhere to go for Phoenix.
Osgood stopped that bad angle shot. Holmes from there to Draper. Go, go! Draper put on the brakes, send it to the corner. Around for McCarty. McCarty behind the goal, out for Murphy. Back in front. Oh. Go! Holmstrom! What a play by Murphy and McCarty to set up Holmstrom. It's 6-2.
A very sloppy Phoenix in their own zone. I looked at Jim Schoenfeld the minute he realized the puck was in, and he just shook his head down like, I can't believe they scored again. Phoenix very lax defensively around the net. I mean, the defenseman Gagnon took the wrong route around. Murphy just smartly goes back to the front. Nobody covers Holmstrom. And he chips it by the goaltender. The goaltender's got no chance in this play. The defenseman's got to stay home in front of the net. You can't leave your position in front of the net. When you do, bad things happen, and Red Wings just are blowing this thing wide open. That makes it 6-2, doesn't it? Only
yes.
Get 5 on the board.
It's 6, all right, and Thomas Holmstrom has his 10th goal of the season. And now has a 5-game point streak for Thomas Holmstrom. With 2 goals and 5 points in that time. Remember, Holmstrom had gone 24 games without one. And now has 2 in rapid succession. Holmstrom from Murphy and McCarty. So give Murphy 2 assists tonight. 6 Red Wings with multiple points here this evening. Holmstrom from Murphy and McCarty at 15-25, 6-2 for Detroit. brought in here. Kozlov, nice little move. Langkow had it on his skates and figures, the way things have gone, I just better take a seat and hang on. Thomas Holmstrom has made it 6-2. McCarty to Murphy. Holmstrom, well, he's always in front of the net. Bangs it home. We're back in a moment. Point. We'll take this face off. The point with Larionov and Kozlov. Larionov kicking at it. Here's the point. 6-2, Detroit leading. Red Wings beat Vancouver 7-1 back on November 27th for the most goals this season. We'll look to add to their total here. 3 minutes to go, second period. Up by 4. Slapped around by McCowan. Dandineau has a goal here tonight, muscled it to center. Phoenix pushes it back in. Slavik Kozlov with a goal and a helper, slaps it back into the Coyote zone. Aaron Ward back to touch it, icing against Phoenix, who beat Detroit 6-2 back at the Joe on December 22nd. So that's a little bit of revenge with a Red Wings 6-2 lead here. And as you mentioned, they scored 7 versus Vancouver November the 27th. The Coyotes have had trouble scoring. Only 4 10-plus goal scorers on this team. Second fewest in the league to Tampa Bay. Detroit has 8 who've scored 10-plus goals. Tkachuk with 24 now, Tkachuk at 22, and Roenick with 20 have accounted for 43% of the Coyote goals. And Greg Adams hurt tonight is the only other 10-plus goal scorer on this club. So when they get down by this many, tough to come back. And the Red Wings are really fired up after that 5-day break. Mick, you mentioned during that loss to the Islanders, we can go to more of the last game Detroit played before this one, that the team was just tired and really needed the break.
Oh, absolutely. Mentally tired.
And all their men tied up in their own zone, allowing Brown to carry out. Dropping for Roost. The shot, and rifled it high over the left hand of Langkow. That'll be knifed through by Stephen Leitch. He'll head to the bench. Stacy Roost will backhand one into the Coyote zone after gaining center ice to negate an icing. Newman, who's had a subpar season by his standards, fed ahead for Tkachuk, who couldn't take it. Lidstrom. Newman, first man back, can't clear. Went off Draper, intercepted. Holmstrom behind the goal for Draper. Back for Holmstrom, who's made it 6-2 here in the second. Similar play, he got the last one on. McCarty out front himself, jamming at it, and Roenick will gobble up that loose puck. Boy, the Red Wings able to come out in front at will. Knocked down at the line, Roenick will turn back. Jeremy Roenick, who recently broke an 8-game goal slump with a goal in Boston, albeit in a 3-2 loss Tuesday. Roenick early on this season was on pace for 100 points. He's got 53 now, so that tells you how much he's slowed down.
Yeah, he and Tkachuk both really went into a drought at the same time, and that's why this team has struggled. But they don't score, this team isn't going to win.
Albeit they were both hurt for a while along with Drake. Remember, their whole top line was down after they got off to that great start, yet they didn't give up the goals like they're giving up now.
In fairness, Tkachuk has played He's played some games where he hasn't been anywhere near 100% as well. So
he's missed 14 due to injury. Here's Briere's shot went wide. And the second period comes to a close. But what a big one it was. The Red Wings led 2-1 after 20 minutes. They scored 4 to the Coyotes 1 in the middle stanza to lead it 6-2. Brendan Shanahan scoring 2 within 55 seconds of play. Scotty Bowman's troops take a 4-goal lead to the dressing room after 40 minutes. Murphy with 2 assists, Shanahan a couple of goals, Eisenman a goal and an assist, Larionov 2 assists, Kozlov 1-1, and Nick Lidstrom 2 helpers. We check in now. Ray Lane standing by with one of the goal scorers, Matthew Dandenault.
Yeah. Guys are going by right now. We're right here. Red Wings coming off and feeling pretty good about themselves. Matthew Dandenault, our special guest, as he picks up his 10th goal of the campaign. Nice going. Great pass from Kozlov, and you were steady.
Yeah. I mean, Kozlov, obviously playing with those guys, it's amazing, you know, how much skill they got, and they always seem to be open. You just got to find them and then get to the open space, and that's why they're so good. So that's why I just try to do get the open space. And made a great play.
And you're a one-timer, and you didn't waste any time on it.
Well, look, I mean, Cousins sucked everybody in, and it's just a nice little pass, man. You know, I was already turning, just ready to gun it. I mean, no matter what, I was going to swing for it.
And you moved up in the play.
Yeah, I mean, that's it's one of my jobs, you know, try to move up and get to the offensive chances when it's open. I mean, you can't always go all the time. I get knocked on a little bit because trying to get the offensive side a lot, but I mean, it's one of the reasons why they got me back there, just to get the open space, help the rush.
And the general manager at dinner last night said you could just look for him being a defenseman in the league, whether you like it or not, babe.
I'm really enjoying it. I get a lot of ice time, and, you know, I'm just thrilled to be playing a lot.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Right.
6-2 Red Wings after 2 periods of play. We're coming right back to Phoenix, but right now we'll take a brief but important timeout.
Ken Daniels, Mickey Redmond, Ray Lane back here in Phoenix. It is 6-2, the Red Wings after 40 minutes of play. And third period underway. Detroit outscored the Coyotes 4-1 in that middle period. Sent ahead, knocked down by Eisenman. Malpe, he'll send it through. Intercepted by Shanahan, back in front, and Malpe going after him. Tried to sweep it around for Eisenman, he gets bumped by Numanen. So really what's left to be decided here is, will Brendan Shanahan get 3 tonight, which would be his 2nd of the season and 12th of his career. He'll try a long shot, and Linecow made the save. Stolen by McCarty. Wide open, the shot, it got blocked. McCowan moving in, he'll sweep it off to an open wing. Darren Quint, first man on it for Phoenix. Shoveled it out to center, Red Wings take over. Holmstrom took that pass nicely. Ran out of room. He was bumped, keeps on it. Puck came free, taken by Teppo Newman. He'll flip it down the ice. Osgood, when he came out to play it, that'll negate any icing. Dandenault, Tkachuk in front, Osgood down, and Tkachuk shooting for his hat trick was stopped by Chris Osgood.
Strange play, Osgood now talking to Dandenault about communication on who's going where and who's on first. And that's so important back in your own zone. They've added an assist, it looks like, Kenny. Go ahead, and I'll get to it in a second.
Igor Larionov. We've been getting a lot of inquiries regarding our Mishkon shorthanded challenge when we announce the name. That person wins $50 in Red Wing merchandise if the Wings score shorthanded. If you'd like to participate, send your name, address, and phone number to Mishkon shorthanded challenge, Box 50, Southfield, Michigan, 48037. You must be 18 or older to enter. So Igor Larionov picks up an assist on the Dandenault goal, along with Kozlov, who already had one, on the 5th Red Wing goal. So Igor Larionov now with a 3 assists night. giving Igor Larionov 24 points now, his past 18 games. And his 39 assists lead the team. In for Horkum, but out of his reach. Or for Drake, rather. Drake on it. Drake sent it toward the goal, knocked down by Igor Larionov, ahead to Kozlov. Now to McCowan. Lapointe took a bump. His shot wide of the goal. Dallas Drake on it. Drake, who's missed a lot of time due to injury, 17 games this season, sent it down the ice, and this will be icing. Faceoff coming back into the Phoenix zone. Jan Golubovsky has been steady in his time with the Red Wings, now in his 12th game. Disheartened group of Coyotes who just can't seem to get it on track. Rick Tocchet, as Mick mentioned, 22 goals, matching his jersey number. His savior is a man by the name of T.R. Goodman, who does his work surrounded by muscleheads at the original Gold's Gym in Venice, California. Every June, Tocchet packs his bags for 3 months of pain. At first, it was just Tocchet and Chelios, but now that list has about 30 NHL players, including Roenick, Teverdoski, Rob Blake, Adam Graves, Bob Probert, many all heading out to California. Tocchet says he works so hard, by the time the 82-game season comes around, it's less pain than working out in California under their watchful eye. Pass through to Tocchet, and Osgood will hang on to that.
I would think Osgood's getting a little bit tired of getting whacked and bumped here. He's been run into and interfered with about four different times in this game, and goalies don't take lightly to that kind of stuff. That's how they get hurt. They're not expecting to get hit. Here again, he gets bumped and jolted. You're not expecting to get hurt. You're not, you know, bracing yourself and protecting yourself. That's when you do get injured. And that's when he starts to wield that big goal stick up there and that big paddle and try to protect his face. So you come around here, you're going to chew on some of this once in a while, and you're not so likely to come running into me. Tocchet covered pretty well by Klima, but again, it hurts Hansen, big Hansen, jamming the Red Wing back checker right into Osgood.
By the by, Igor Larionov with those three assists tonight, Mick, give him 50 points on the season. Coming into play tonight, he had tied his high of last year at 47. So now 50 points in the year for Igor Larionov. As mentioned, 24 points his past 18 games, including this one tonight. He and Kozlov and Lapointe, that line's just been dynamite. Remember the Red Wings without Sergei Fedorov tonight. But you know, when a big gunner goes down, Mick, you just look at what the Rangers have done of late. As that hops over Quinn Stick, Wayne Gretzky hurt. Peter Nedved's picked up the slack. Mike Kanula had two big goals last night. Here comes Yzerman, who's always going well. Yzerman in, the save by Lankow. Maltby steals, and he'll be the beneficiary of Fedorov being knocked down to the ice. Van Matsenhoven right there. Holmstrom in to steal to Draper. Back in front for McCarty. Couldn't get a shot away in the Coyotes. Four of them up. Stapleton sent through. Osgood sticked it aside. Holmstrom back the other way. Here comes Draper to take it. Draper in, and the shot deflected. Opt in and up into the seats and out of play. It is 6-2, the Red Wings leading Phoenix. We played 4:09 here, third period. 6-2, Red Wings advantage here in Phoenix. What do you got there?
I got about 75 of these. So all you folks who are back home, they called and said, we're going to get a hello to you. We just did it. All these gang, Red Wing fans everywhere up here. We appreciate it. And we're saying hello to all you back home waiting for those notes from all the fine folks out here in Phoenix supporting the Red Wings here as they roll up a 6-2 lead right now.
Yes, we do appreciate all the hellos, but you find sometimes, though, the game gets in the way.
Yeah, right. Well, I bet you I'm close to 100 here tonight.
Oh, yeah.
There's just no way we can get them all in, but we do the best we can. But we appreciate all the Red Wing support. Penalty there. Hooked on Drake. Not much question about that.
Well, Phoenix with two power play goals tonight, both by Tkachuk. We'll go to the power play again.
Game has sold out over 16,000 in this arena that was made for basketball. As Ken mentioned earlier in the show, they're having a vote on whether they should build a new arena or renovate. There's talk that they may renovate the one end of this arena. As you look at the penalty taken for hooking on Dallas Drake, this one end, you can't see the play if you're up on top. Once it comes over the Phoenix blue line above the goaltender, you got to look at the big screen to see the play. Well, that's not a good situation. They'd like to renovate that by moving the whole end of the building back out.
Eric Coyotes are on a power play. And Osgood will grab hold of that. Robert Maliki of Harper Woods is the Mishkon shorthanded challenger. If the Wings score during this penalty kill, Robert will win $50 in Red Wing merchandise. Larry Murphy with two assists tonight. Igor Larionov with three, the leader in that department. Brendan Shanahan with two goals, the leader in that. Cardi gave it away behind the goal, and the Coyotes give it away, sending it all the way back into their own zone. That's the way it's gone for a power play that is ranked second worst in the National Hockey League, although they have two tonight. Worst in the league at home, including tonight. They are five for the last 49 attempts. With the two tonight, they've broken 0 for 13 skid. Coming into this one, safe to say that penalty killing for Detroit had been a concern of Scotty Bowman of late. Here, Brown tying up Tockett. McCowan will try the other way. Here's Tkachuk. Nice pass through skates. Newman stopped by Osgood. Clear.
Onside.
Here's a break. A race for the puck, and Langkow will beat Doug Brown to it. Red Wings prior to tonight had allowed four power play goals against their last three games, although they did score one shorthanded by this guy, Malfi, to Draper. And that's up high, up into the seats and out of play. Didn't really get good wood on that shot.
Well, I'm thinking of Dallas Drake as I watch him go off the ice. Phoenix is, you know, they were very emotional, very intense in the first period. But they, as time's gone on in this game, they've made some very bad mistakes mentally, some bad choices on decisions, and it's cost them dearly. And plus, they took a couple of bad penalties that Detroit capitalized on, and that's really been the story of this game. And here in the third period, Phoenix isn't showing a whole lot of emotion at all. They've kind of messed up, and not much they can do about it now. As a matter of fact, there's nothing they can do about it now except try to get it corrected for the next game.
Knocked back by Detroit, taken by Tverdovsky, number 10, to Corkum, fed it through. Fans wanted another penalty.
I don't blame them. That could have been called very easily.
Manuel had been knocked down to the ice. Kozlov turns, penalty over. So Phoenix 2-for-4 now on the power play. Tipped through by Stacy Roos. Tverdovsky. He'll lead it ahead. Knocked down at center. Backpedaling Jan Golubovsky, along with Aaron Ward, have played a very steady game tonight. Doug Brown shooting it in. And the way that they've come along, you have to feel that when the Red Wings get back Todd Gill, and if Huey Krupp can return, the good defense.
And all these guys are on the trip. Gilchrist is here, hopes to play near the end of the trip. Krupp is here, probably see a doctor when we get to L.A. Going tonight, be there for a few days. Gill is here.
Even Joe Koser made the trip.
Koser, yeah, the whole bunch. Joe's dad, who's from Saskatchewan, spending some time out here. I saw him in the hotel lobby this morning.
And there wasn't much room left on Redbird. Kozlov. Pocket. Pocket at center. Long shot, Stapleton missed on the stick side. McCarty giving chase on it. Hill carry down right wing side. McCarty wheeling, couldn't put it into the corner. Holmstrom into help. Back to the line. Dandino gave it away, tried to send it through. Got it right back though from Tockett, and this time will get it in. Holmstrom back for Draper. McCowan at the point, and Lankow stopped it with McCarty screening in front. Tkachuk couldn't get it out. Holmstrom to McCarty. Behind the goal, Draper will go after it. Mike Stapleton on it. Stapleton closed out of the play by Draper. McCarty in to help him out, but it'll be taken there by J.J. Daniel. Fed ahead, McCowan back to beat Dallas Drake to the puck. At center, flipped in by Thomas Holmstrom. Neumannen cleared it around for Baron Quint, number 5. Drake just got it to center. Red Wings will take over. Shanahan, 2-goal scorer tonight. Out there along with Yzerman and Maltby. As mentioned, Maltby picking up the time on this line. What with Fedorov to miss the next 5 games. Fedorov won't return until the Red Wings meet Phoenix again on St. Patrick's Day at the Joe once this 5-game road trip is over. Red Wings will take on Anaheim Sunday night. 8 o'clock Detroit time on UPN 50. Roenick.
Line combination. Jimmy Cummins is out with Roenick and Tkachuk.
Remember Cummins last time in here gave the Red Wings fits.
He scored a goal, didn't he?
Yes,
if I remember correctly. And he doesn't get many, Jimmy.
No. Here he is with it. Right wing side, number 15, Cummins. Now in his 8th season. Couple with Detroit. Sean Gagnon, Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario native, to an open wing, goes and gets it. Aaron Ward played it around. Lapointe ahead for an on-rushing Kozlov. Beaten to it by J.J. Daniel, and Igor Larionov is back in his own zone. Martin Lapointe took a bump but cleared it out. Kozlov onside. He'll flip it in.
Well, this game's just going back and forth now. Detroit pretty much got it wrapped up. Phoenix doesn't have a whole lot left in them after being in the game and then out of it on the 5th goal. That really killed them. And they just want to get retooled for their next one, and Detroit will head right to Anaheim tonight to face the red hot Mighty Ducks, who are home to Nashville tonight, who beat LA last night and hurt their playoff chances. They're home tonight playing, and they'll play 5 o'clock on Sunday right here on UPN 50, or 8 o'clock Detroit time.
And how about it, if Red Wings will continue on to win here, and should Anaheim win tonight, they'll move within 3 points of the Coyotes for the 4th seed in the West. Osgood stopped it, tipped it out of the air. McCowan knocked it down, swept it along. Turning is Carney. Tverdovsky, head shot, and Osgood saw that all the way and hangs on. 8:25 to go here in the third period. Chris Osgood has come up big, has faced 33 Phoenix shots and some in acrobatic style. While the Red Wings with a road record of 12-15-4 will improve to just 2 games under 500 now, the Red Wings have not been below 500 on the road since the 90-91 season, before Scotty Bowman arrived. And really, this road trip will tell the tale, and this team needs confidence going on the road, especially coming into the playoffs.
Well, they've got 5 games in 12 days, so there is some time off, and I think the 5-day layoff from last Saturday night in Long Island, which was a poor hockey game, and to this game tonight, has done wonders for them mentally and physically. And I think some time in California in between games also is going to be welcomed, especially by some of the veteran players. I mean, Larionov didn't skate this morning. You know, these guys aren't going to skate a lot when they don't have to the rest of the way. I mean, it's just, you don't win any games in the pregame skates in the morning.
Don't leave it at the rink.
No, you don't. And Scotty Bowman knows that. Murphy, Lidstrom, they've been getting lots of rest.
Murphy fed it through to Draper. Roenick. Hill fired in. Osgood to leave it for Jan Golubovsky. Golubovsky got whacked hard. And they're offside at the line as Leach was in ahead of the play and now gets it up with Golubovsky. Leach was the man who hit him.
That's what he needs to do, and that's exactly why Scotty Bowman's playing Golubovsky here. Phoenix is liable to, you know, explode here, being embarrassed at home. And Golubovsky needs this kind of experience against a tough team in their own building. This is a learning experience for this young man. He got belted pretty hard, and he could have, you know, with a little bit of experience, he might have smelled this coming, but he didn't. And that's what it's all about. Learning how to recognize situations and avoid doing it again. See, he's struggling with the puck. At that point, you know what? Give it up. Protect yourself. You know, just out of his reach, and he didn't like it. You know, Leach has been a little bit feisty here for no reason in the third period.
And now let's get this word from Lumberjack.
Score big savings with Lumberjack Building Centers.
Tell them Gordie Howe sent you.
A little too warm out here,
Gordie,
for flannel.
Huh?
A little too warm out here for flannel.
It's never too warm for a flannel, believe me. I brought one with me on the road trip. You'll see it in California. I wouldn't go out in the sun with it, let's put it that way, but
good.
It gets pretty cold in the desert at night.
So two apiece to Leach and to Golubovsky. Two each for roughing. Phoenix Coyotes, we mentioned their start when they got off to that 17-3-3 beginning. But at that time, Phoenix had only played 23 games in 64 days.
Yeah.
They had a lot of off time for practice, to gear down. They had no injuries. Then they played 37 games in 70 days. So almost one every two. 13-18-7 is how they went. So it tells
look out,
you
here we go.
Schedule's
Shanahan.
Up. Shanahan for three. Shanahan has it. The hat trick.
What a
for Brendan Shanahan.
What a shot.
Look at the hat glittering the ice here in Phoenix.
Oh my.
Red Wing fans may want him for the Sun tomorrow, but they don't want him here tonight.
Boy, did he make a shot, Brendan Shanahan, my goodness.
His 12th career hat trick and his fifth as a Detroit Red Wing for Brendan Shanahan.
Well, a perfect pass that dumped over the right defenseman's stick. Shanahan was onside, picked it up at all kinds of time, penalty shot fashion, to set it up, get the puck to settle down and stop rolling. Waits, boom, he deflects it off the catching glove of the goaltender. Watch this. Well, I'm not sure. The first one looked like it went off his right arm, but boy, it's right up underneath the bar where it meets the goalpost. It's 7-2. The Tour de Chapeau for Brendan Shanahan, and it rains hats all over America West.
Oh, it was littered here. Brendan Shanahan, he had scored three earlier this season in the home opener, banner-raising night against the St. Louis Blues, his former club. And here, Brendan Shanahan gets three to give him 25 on the season. Eight goals his past 15 games, three of those coming here tonight for Brendan Shanahan.
And to boot, it's shorthanded here. Dandino with the pass. That thing just bounces. And Shanahan's away to the races. Yeah, that looked like it deflected off the trapper and up underneath the bar, but. Well, everything going Detroit's way tonight. And well, it's 7-2.
Well, shorthanded in that they're both four aside.
Oh, I'm sorry. No, I'm wrong now. I thought it was a shorthanded situation.
Here's Tkachuk going through, and Osgood swept it away.
Thanks for trying, though.
That's all right. Yeah.
I was thinking when they were shorthanded when Yzerman took that face off, and I just kept believing it.
Here's Yzerman. His shot, and Lankow stopped it.
It's one of those, it's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
You can try. Dandino now with an assist on the Shanahan goal, so he's another one in multiple points tonight with a goal and an assist for Matthew Dandino. So the Red Wings, with seven here tonight, have matched their season high from against Vancouver in late November. Shanahan with a reason to smile. Three tonight, seven for the Wings. Brendan Shanahan with his 12th career hat trick and his fifth as a Detroit Red Wing, his second this season. Shanahan now with 25 goals. Larionov. Drake to Numanen. That'll be offside as Briere stepped in ahead of the play. Finally, the Ultimate Red Wing Hockey Show, debuting on UPN 50 Sunday, March 14th, and it stars Ray Lane and Mickey Redmond. Not about X's and O's, it's about the guys who are your Stanley Cup champions. Ray and Mickey will show you what they do away from the game and what they're really like. Mickey actually goes on the ice with the players during practice. You won't see that anywhere else. Ray and Mickey on Ice premieres Sunday, March 14th at 11, right after STV, only on UPN 50.
Much to Fedorov's chagrin, that's not Sergei television.
This will be icing against Detroit. So the faceoff will come back into the Red Wings zone. The shots are 36-26 favoring Phoenix. Doesn't mean much, does it, when the Red Wings lead 7-2?
No, it really doesn't. But outside of the fact that it's cost Sergei $400,000 or thereabouts because of the fine, and I should explain that what happened on the five-game suspension, of course, Kenny, it's prorated to 82 games. And it's whatever percentage of 82 being five is, around 16% roughly, of his pay. And what they did is they guesstimated his pay. They didn't guesstimate. They took it at about $6.5 million, even though he's only making $2 million this year. Somehow they took it into consideration of the contract that he got and all the money last year. And on one side, they said they could have used $14 million. But they only use 6.5, and here I'm thinking they're using two. So, I mean, who's to say? But it cost them darn near $400,000, and once you bite the bullet on that, go from there, the rest isn't going to hurt them, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm.
With 5 weeks left in the season.
Here comes a flying Draper, put on the brakes. He'll turn it back into the corner. Maltby in there along with Tverdovsky. This the most goals the Coyotes have allowed at home this season. Seven previously ties their high. Edmonton beat them 7-1 here, so it equals that. And at Florida on the recent road trip, the Florida Panthers spanked Phoenix 7-1 six games ago. So Phoenix has been struggling of late, and here the Red Wings get seven. Detroit matching their season high for an output. For the Coyotes, Stapleton had no room to go. Osgood covered that short side. Jim Cummins in to grab it. Steve Leach in front. He elects to go behind to Stapleton in front of the goal, and Osgood made the save. Coming up quickly was Gagnon from his point position. 4:20 to go here, third period. Coyotes in again. Leach, his shot way wide. Gagnon to stop left point. Knocked down in front. Two Coyotes were open. Puck never got through. Roost to move it ahead. Stacy Roost can't get past. Klima will put it in behind the goal. Roost and Klima will head to the bench. Larionov will be joined by his linemates Lapointe and Kozlov. Larionov, three assists tonight. Kozlov with a goal and a helper. Quint at the point. Osgood out to stop it. Saw it all the way, and he'll hang on to that one. 3:44 to go in the third. All Red Wings in the desert. We're back in a moment. 7-0 during regular business hours are stopped by the Joe Louis Arena box office. Brendan Shanahan out there again looking for four goals. The seven allowed by Phoenix here tonight, the most in this building ever for the Coyotes. Not that they've been here that long since coming from Winnipeg. Briere is in. And on the Shanahan goal from Dandino that made it 7-2, they've now added an assist to Chris Osgood. So he picks up an assist as well to go along with his fine goaltending tonight as Ward and Yzerman are all in there. A little face washing taking place. 3:07 to go here in the third. 7-2 Detroit. We're back in a moment on UPN 50. It's right here on UPN 50 Sunday night. And many of these fans who made the trek here to Phoenix will just move on up to Anaheim.
Yeah. I mean, how about, you know, you're talking 3 points away. How about what it was a couple weeks ago that Anaheim came back and beat Phoenix? And in a post-game conference, you know, Craig Hartford was talking about it. I guess Jim Schoenfeld made the comment that, we got points to waste. And,
Don't think so.
Well,
yeah.
Not now, that's for sure. I mean, at the time, that might have looked that way, and here you are all of a sudden. Holy smoke.
Well, what are the Mighty Ducks now? They're past 14 going in tonight. They're like 11-3?
I think 11-3 their last 14. Red hot.
Mm-hmm.
Jack Ferraro, their general manager, was here tonight.
Flip to the line. Not out. Second attempt. Golubovsky takes over. Ahead for Roost. He'll put it in behind the net. Tverdovsky almost stripped of the puck by Klima. Left wing side. In his Parkham. What a great defensive play by Jan Golubovsky.
Spoke there, Pierre Gauthier, the general manager, but hockey operations chief Ferrara, he's here doing some scouting for Sunday's game. You can bet, if not, looking for possibilities to improve his hockey club with a trade.
Aaron Ward. Holmstrom, nice work to stay onside, straddling that blue line. Now goes in there, slammed hard by Carney. Then Tockett. He muscles in along with Draper, who's lost his helmet. Draper dumped behind the play and a penalty coming up here to Tockett.
Now that leads all the way back to second period. Remember when Tockett was upset with Draper and McCarty comes in immediately and says, not for that, Rick.
Fine line between playing a hitting game and a discipline game.
Yeah.
And the Coyotes really haven't done that tonight, although now I guess you could excuse them with it 7-2 and just 1:19 to go. And well.
Not done yet. We're not done yet. Not enough linesmen to keep everybody apart.
And remember this too, they don't have long to wait till they meet again, just March 17th back at Joe Louis Arena.
This is about a split second away from a punch being thrown here.
Phoenix beat Detroit at the Joe 6-2 back on December 22nd. And oh, some 10 weeks later or so, it's all Red Wings a little payback here tonight. Detroit has bettered Phoenix by one than what they did to them prior to Christmas. It's 7-2, 1:19 to play. Back with the conclusion to Phoenix in a moment.
Now Rick Tockett behind the play. Van Massenhoven there to make the call. A little extra curricular on Chris Draper. That went back to the second period. Nothing serious. Not a good penalty anyway, but it doesn't matter. A minute 19 to go, and it's 7-2, so.
Look at the Red Wing fan showing Rick Tockett a thing or two, and Tockett squirts him through the glass. Oh, now the Red Wings and Coyote fans, are they going to have it out?
Well, they're.
Fedorov's been suspended already. He could be kicked out.
There's a guy with a Tockett jersey there that's really giving it verbally to one of the Red Wing fans with his
Fedorov
jersey on. Was it a Fedorov?
Yes, there he is. Well, we're not having the fights on the ice. We could have one in the seats here tonight, but let's hope nothing further develops out of that. As they'll get in between them.
So far, it's just a lot of chin music.
Yep. We're on the Bell Tire power play with Tockett in the box. Or Megan Gallagher of Ferndale, our Bell Tire power play partner.
Oh, boy.
The Red Wings 2-for-4 in the power play tonight.
Klima's open.
Pass to him. Klima alone. Oh, and just can't finish. Hedlund cow down, and Klima in a bit too far. Brendan Shanahan standing over at the Red Wing bench, not out there though. Klima rink wide, and that shot by Roos goes high. So Scotty Bowman giving some others a chance to maybe get on the board here. 25 seconds to go. Osgood, who picked up his third assist of the season here tonight, leaves it for Dandino. So the Red Wings use their game in hand on the Avalanche tonight and put it to good use, tying Colorado again for second seed in the Western Conference. The Red Wings with those 5 days off, full value. One last shot. Golubovsky stuffed by Lankow. The game is over. The Red Wings win it 7-2 over the Phoenix Coyotes to snap a four-game winless skid.
Well, first game back was a problem, as it turned out, for Phoenix. They came out of the gate just flying, and I didn't think it was going to be. They were hitting, they were banging, they were running the net, interfering with Osgood, and we had a 1-1 game, and then they took a bad penalty, and Yzerman capitalized on the power play to get his 25th. They went on to a 4-1 lead. It was made 4-2. And then the Dandino goal just broke their backs, and it was downhill from there from Phoenix. So the Red Wings did everything right. Coyotes make some bad decisions, and it cost them dearly.
Well, Mickey and I'll return here in Phoenix in just a couple of minutes. We take you right now to the UPN 50 10 o'clock news.